Hello everyone, my name is Tax Alba and welcome back to the Lovecraftian Video Game Retrospective and welcome to Arkham After Midnight. Arkham After Midnight is a roguelike game and its core feature is that it doesn't randomly generate environments. The environments are actually pre-built and all of them are set in Arkham. There's a library, a cemetery, the harbor and a couple more environments and places you can go to, but the random element of the game is enemy placement and story. So what you do is you move around, you do the usual stuff, you face enemies, you collect items, you collect clues, and you try to survive, and the clues actually open up new places and they determine what you actually need to do within the specific scenario. There's about 6 or 7 scenarios, and depending on which one you get, it's randomly chosen. You may have to find a special weapon to defeat a supernatural enemy, or you might have to find certain items in a certain place. It's actually quite interesting because over time you do get familiar with the places, but it doesn't necessarily mean that you know what to do as opposed to other roguelikes where your dungeon might be randomly generated, but you generally know what to do in the sense of find the exit and avoid enemies and collect items. The game isn't really all that long, which is actually good in my opinion because it is a little bit of an anti-frustration feature. So if you do die and you do fail, it does mean you can get back where you started to relatively quickly. The game is also free and was created for a contest within 7 days, and for that it's actually quite a nice piece of work. The music and sound aren't really all that remarkable, but the game looks quite nice. It has a bit of a 16-bit era look, but generally we don't really expect fancy graphics from roguelikes. In fact, a lot of roguelikes deliberately have quite simplistic graphics, and for what it tries to achieve is actually kind of neat. I wish the game would be expanded a little bit, and I could actually see the idea behind it being expanded into a larger game. Of course, it's a bit more difficult to write a ton of stories and make them interact properly, especially if not only the stories are randomly chosen, but also elements within the stories are generated. But nonetheless, I think it's quite a nice idea, and since the game is free, I would suggest that you do check it out. And unless you're opposed to roguelike, then you're probably not going to like it. The game overall is not too difficult. The game gives you quite a good bit of ammunition with the start, and the goons are very easy to handle. The supernatural creatures are not, but then again, in most scenarios, the goal to winning is actually overcoming a supernatural creature, so that's more of a feature than a bug. Thanks for watching, and I shall see you next time. Take care, and goodbye.